Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Alana Jordan. St. Louis, Missouri. 'Twas noontide of summer, and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon, mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dear thy beam shall be, for joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Anne Cheng. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Andrea Fiore. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon, mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee. Proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Annie Kirkpatrick. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Anna Roberts. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, And I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be, for joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Anders Lankford. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon, mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed, as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe, read for LibriVox.org by Betsy Bush, January 2009. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than thy colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe, read for LibriVox.org by Carol Stripling. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee. Proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by David Fetterman. 'Twas noontide of summer, and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe, read for LibriVox.org by David Lawrence, January 19, 2009, in Brampton, Ontario. 'Twas noontime of summer, at midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star. In thy glory afar and dear thy beam shall be, for joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night. And more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Ernst Patinama. January the 20th, 2009. Amsterdam, the Netherlands. It was noontide of summer, and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed, as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star. In thy glory afar and dearer thy beam shall be, for joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night. And more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe, read for LibriVox.org by Esther. 'Twas noontide of summer, and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Glenn Simonson. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dear thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Great Plains. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Hannah Dowell. 'Twas noontide of summer, and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me, they passed as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Gemma Blythe. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me, there passed as a shroud, a fleecy cloud. And I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Jason Mills. 22nd January 2009, Accrington, UK. 'Twas noontide of summer, and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Jim Fish on the Texas Frontier on January the 19th, 2009. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee. Proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Kristen Hughes. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee. Proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Leanne Howlett. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud, a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Evan Barnes. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee. Proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Nick Number. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon, mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by P. D. Wright. 'Twas noontide of summer and the mid-time of night, and stars in their orbit shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon, mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in the glory afar, and the dearer thy beams shall be, for joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire the distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Rhonda Fetterman. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee. Proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Raven Notation. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Secrets. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars, in their orbits, shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee. Proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe. Read for LibriVox.org by Scott Miller. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter, cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe, read for LibriVox.org by Tracy Datlin. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon, mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed a while on her cold smile, too cold, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away. To thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
Evening Star by Edgar Allan Poe, read for LibriVox.org by Tricia G. 'Twas noontide of summer and midtime of night, and stars in their orbits shone pale through the light of the brighter cold moon. Mid planets her slaves, herself in the heavens, her beam on the waves. I gazed awhile on her cold smile, too cold for me. There passed as a shroud a fleecy cloud, and I turned away to thee, proud evening star, in thy glory afar, and dearer thy beam shall be. For joy to my heart is the proud part thou bearest in heaven at night, and more I admire thy distant fire than that colder, lowly light. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.